Let us see the structure and configuration of ceramics, refractories, and insulators. Ceramics. The term ceramics is used to denote those products which are made from inorganic materials and have non-metallic properties. Ionically bonded magnesia MgO and covalently bonded silicon carbide SiC are the simple examples of ceramics. The traditional ceramic materials are stone, brick, concrete, clay, glass, vitreous, enamel, and refractories. Majority of these are composed of silicates. So here this is a construction of crystal of Si and silicon and oxygen. Here are some examples of ceramics. Spark plug. This is ceramic bearings, ceramic gears, ceramic impellers, and some small components of ceramic materials. Ceramics have high melting points. It is because the strong primary bonding like ionic or covalent between the constituent atoms. Materials such as magnesia and alumina. In most of the materials which are used in ceramic is magnesia and aluminum, which have melting points of 2800 degrees centigrade and 2040 degrees centigrade respectively. Made excellent refractory materials for lining of high temperature furnaces. They are also used for metallurgical polishing. Silica particles are used in sandstone and glass paper. Corundum means alumina contaminated with iron oxide is used in energy paper and grinding wheels. Alumina is used for tips of lathe tools. Most ceramics have very low value of thermal conductivity. It is because of the reason that there are no free electrons in the materials. While in metals there are free electrons, so it is highly thermal conductivity. But here this is a non-metal, there are no free electrons in the ceramic material. The weak conduction that does take place in only by transfer or vibrational energy from atom to atom. Hence, ceramic are generally good thermal insulators. So, classification of ceramics on basis of applications. So, ceramics classified in glasses, like glasses, glassy ceramics, then clay products, like structural clay products and whitewares. Refractories like silica, fire clay, basic and special also. Abrasives, cements and advanced ceramics. Glasses. This is the most familiar group of ceramic materials. The typical applications of glasses include containers, windows, lenses and fiberglass. The glasses are non-crystalline silicates containing other oxides such as calcium oxide, sodium oxide, potassium oxide, and aluminum oxide. Clay products. Clay is one of the most widely used ceramic raw material. The clay can be used very easily to form products. When it is mixed in the proper proportionals, clay and water forms a plastic mass that is very flexible for shaping. Broadly speaking, the clay products may be classified into the following two categories. One is structural clay products. These include boiling bricks, tiles, and sewer pipes. White wares. These include porcelain, pottery, tableware, china, and sanitary ware. Refractories. The ceramic materials capable of withstanding high temperatures without appreciable deformation under service conditions are called refractory materials. The ceramic materials such as magnesia with melting point 288 degrees centigrade and alumina with melting point 2040 degrees centigrade are excellent choice as a refractory material. Such materials are used for lining of high temperature furnaces, boilers, crucibles, converters, and support for hot wire, etc. Some common refractory materials are silica, magnesite, dolomite, silicon carbide, zircon, and graphite. So here this is a furnace in which refractory bricks are used, and this is a crucible which is manufactured with the refractory materials. Properties of refractory materials. These materials do not fuse or soften at a temperature at which it is used. These materials have excellent resistance against thermal shock and abrasion. Thermal shocks refers to the sudden changes in temperature. These materials do not crumble or crack under the prevailing pressure when it is used at high temperatures. These materials have low coefficient of thermal conductivity. These materials have high resistance to corrosion and therefore do not react chemically with molten metal or slag in the furnace. These materials have extremely low values of electrical conductivity. So here this is refractory bricks and the physical, thermal, and chemical properties of refractory materials. Insulators. Insulating materials are those which retard or stop the flow of heat, sound, and electricity through them. Insulators assure a safe handling of heat energy and electrical power. So there are three types of insulations: heat insulators, electrical insulators, and sound insulators. Heat insulators like cork fiber boards, asbestos, mineral wool, formed polystyrene, slabs, hollow bricks, cellular rubber, etc. Electrical insulators, so in which we have gases, liquids, and solids. Common electrical insulating materials are mica, asbestos, rubber, paper, synthetic resins, porcelain, glasses, cotton, etc. Sound insulators like fiber boards, glass, cellular concrete, acoustic plaster and boards, and vermicular, etc. So here are some electrical components which must be highly insulated with electricity, and here some thermal insulators are there. Thank you very much for watching this video.